Hey guys, it's Maymay, and today I'm going to show you how to load your ATG gun. I get so many questions about this, actually to the point that whenever we have card parties, we have a group of ladies that we have card parties together, and when I get there, there's usually ATG sitting in my place for me to fill up for them. So I think that's hilarious, and I don't mind doing it at all, but there is a little bit of secret to it, and if you use the instructions on your gun, you should be fine, except for the fact that in my experience, I have found that some guns are wrapped in reverse, or some rolls of tape are wrapped in reverse. Now, this is an actual Scotch roll, but if you have the rolls that maybe you buy for a lot less money, and they're made kind of an off-brand, I find that those tend to be wrapped in reverse. And a lot of times when you buy them, it'll say it. So here's what I do to save myself some headache. First off, let's talk about the gun itself. Now, when you get this, it's going to be closed, and it may be kind of snug, it may be tight, but what you'll do is you can see here there's these little finger grips on this side right here. You're going to press a little bit and then open that up, okay? Now, this shows you the place to put the tape when it's fresh and new. This is where it feeds the first time, and this is the collector for the empty tape backing that will go on this side. Now, you'll want to remove this little guy first, get him out of your way, okay? And then, if you look on your ATG, you have arrows showing you how you should put everything, and normally they work just fine. But I've even had some of the ATG, the Scotch refill, where it seems to get backwards on me, and I'm not sure why. I don't know if maybe the adhesive doesn't come off right, but that happens to me sometimes. So this is what I do. I know that when I load this tape onto this gun, the sticky part needs to be here, okay, because that's the part that's going to touch the paper. So whenever I release this new roll of adhesive, I release it until I get past, let me flip it over, until I get past the plaid part, and this is where the adhesive starts. So I make sure that that sticky adhesive is facing the right direction. I don't even worry about what the gun itself says. I just make sure that when I put this in, the sticky part is going to go the right way. Because if you have a reverse roll, that's going to matter. You want to make sure the sticky part is here. Okay? So what you do with this is you'll just place this in, and there's a little catch. You'll kind of get it in place, and it will eventually lock into place, and that little lip will hold it, this little piece locks down over it. So now I know that my sticky is in the right place, and I take the first wrap, goes over this first roller, through the second roller. At this point, I'm just following my arrows, and then up around, following my arrow, around the actual tape itself, okay? And I kind of just line it up with it and kind of put it in place. Now, there are different ways to load this tape over here. You have this little spot where you can run it through and kind of lock it in, but here's what I did. I took some of the actual sticky tape, and I took some of the adhesive off, and I put it onto that feed dog, this piece right here. So when I wrap this around, it automatically sticks in place. So I just have some of the actual ATG sticky stuck on here so it'll stay. That's just easier for me than trying to feed it through this and that and the other. Now then, you'll put this little guy in place. This one always gives me trouble. I just kind of feel around. I just let it do its thing until it locks into place. Never can exactly find where this goes. There we go. Okay, so I just kind of mess around until it goes in place. Now it's ready to be used, but what I want to do is get a scratch piece of paper. Before I do this, I want to talk to you about this. By putting the adhesive on your roller back here and sticking this down to it, it keeps you from wasting extra tape, because you don't have to roll this so much to lock it in place. Actually, at this point, you can see that on my roller, I still have the plaid. So once I start rolling it, the adhesive is going to actually start onto my page, and I don't waste any of it. So I just make sure that it's rolling well, and it is. And it will do that, and it will load itself up just like it's supposed to. And when it's finished, you'll just take this piece off, open this piece up, and unwrap all of the leftover, because it's just trash, and you'll just start over. The biggest thing for me that I found to be the hardest part was knowing how to do this part of the tape. If you make sure your sticky is always where it should be, you shouldn't have any problem, because like I said, some of these are rolled in reverse. So just because you take it off and think it should go one way, it's always important to check where the sticky is. So that's it. Now to use an ATG, you have this little trigger. You put your little nozzle where you want that glue to go. You roll it, release the trigger, and pull back, and it comes loose. So now you probably can't see it, but my adhesive starts right there, and it is right there. So that's where I rolled it down. So I hope that helps you with loading yours. It may be a little different than what you've heard before, but I think that each roll of tape is different. That's what I found anyway. So if you have any questions, just leave them in the comment section below. And otherwise, I hope you have fun with your ATG. By the way, it works the same way for the big guy. So if you have the big one, it's the same deal. Just make sure that sticky is in the right direction. All right, guys, have a great day. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.